Now we're going to spend the entire evening with Trisha Yearwood. Yeah. Oh. Here she is singing her current single, "There Goes My Baby." Please welcome MTA recording artist Trisha Yearwood. So I've been banned from...
Put that away.
Okay.
Sorry. Bang, please. Please okay. Put it away.
Thank you.
Please, put it away.
Y'all are ganging up on me.
Yeah, hopefully you've got it all out.
Out of my system.
Okay, that's enough.
Okay. The tune you just did before the commercial sounds like a song that I've heard a long time ago. What is it about that tune that just it sounds like, you know, it's been around a long time.
I don't know.
Time.
A lot of people say that. When we were making the video, one of the guys on the crew came up and said, I love the original version of that song. And I just said, yeah, me too, because it was me. And I didn't tell him that, of course.
It was the Platters.
Yeah. And I was talking to my mom last night, and she and a friend of ours, Miss Betty Maxwell, one of my friends back home, said, oh, I courted to that song back in the 50s.
And, oh, wow.
And it would be hard to do. It was written about 2 years ago, I think.
Man. Yeah. Now, do you just let them go sometimes? I mean, do you also let them
leave?
Well,
you know, you don't want to, you know, when people ask you things that you know if you correct them, you'll embarrass them. You don't tell them otherwise. I had a woman one time backstage ask me, how do you balance your career and your marriage and your children? And I, of course, I don't have any children. And I didn't want to make her feel really bad, so I said, well, it's not easy. And she found out later and wrote me a letter and she said, I'm just mortified that I said that. I said, you know, so it's okay. You know, people make mistakes.
You're awfully nice.
Well, you know.
Now, you've got a big thing coming up this weekend. Is it the closing ceremonies at the Goodwill Games?
Yeah, going up to New York to sing at the Goodwill Games.
What a good day.
I'm excited. Yeah, it'll be fun.
Yeah.
I'm not doing any gymnastics or anything. I'm just saying.
You sure?
Well, I'm not sure. We'll find out.
I believe you should.
I hope not.
I believe maybe you should.
I'm a singer. That's what I do.
Did you do any kind of track or anything in school?
No, I played softball.
Softball?
Yeah.
You have an interesting pastime on the road.
Well, yeah.
I was shocked when I heard this. She plays hockey.
Ice hockey.
Ice hockey.
Mm-hmm.
This just shocks me.
Well, it shocks me too.
How long have you been doing this?
Well, if you're on the Garth Brooks tour, you end up playing every sport that you never thought you could ever play, and it's kind of like, if you don't go, then, you know, you're a wimp.
Right.
So, of course, when they said they were all going to go play ice hockey, I said, I'll just go back and watch a movie in the hotel. And they were like, Garth, of course, was like, you're
going.
No, that's fine. Don't go. You'll be fine. We'll go play. We'll go do it. If you're not, you know, man enough to go. And I'm like, I'm man enough. I'm there.
Yeah.
And I went. And
well, here. There's the river control in here.
And you. Thank you. Anyway, so we put the full pads on, the helmet.
Away my toy.
You can get it back at the end of the show.
Okay.
Full pads, the whole bit. I have never been on ice skates ever.
Are you like checking guys into the glass and
stuff?
Oh,
no, I'm not checking. I'm falling down without anybody touching me. So the first time we went, you know, there's a circle in the middle. I never got out of the circle. I looked like Tim Conway back on the old Carol Burnett show. Yeah. I'm really going slow, like back and forth. Every time the puck would go, I would turn around and try to get to the other side, and I ended up in the circle the whole time. But I've gotten a little bit better.
Does Garth play?
Yeah.
Is he a pretty good hockey player?
No.
No? Okay. Good. You get the opportunity because you have such, I don't know why. Here's why I think. No, because you have such a versatile voice. You can sing just about whatever gets in the way. And you got the opportunity to sing with Pavarotti.
Yeah.
What was that like?
Oh,
First of all, describe the catering to me.
No, I'm kidding. It was it was in Italy, in his hometown of Modena, which is beautiful. And of course the food gave new meaning to the word Italian. It was just amazing. Yeah. It was incredible. He was incredible. We were told before we got there that we were to address him as Maestro.
Maestro?
Yes. And
like you can't call him by his name, you have to call him Maestro? Yeah.
Louis wasn't really an option.
Not an option.
But he was very nice.
You're supposed to refer to me as El Conquistador.
Nana gave me a different name for you, but I guess that. We can think of a lot. Yeah, you keep that over there. I've got it.
So, Maestro.
Maestro Pavarotti. It was incredible. I didn't know what it would be like, and his voice, when he opens his mouth, I mean, he doesn't need a microphone, you know, and it was just incredible. And I was singing a duet with him.
What did you sing?
We sang O Come All You Faithful in Latin, in Italy.
Probably not. So there wasn't a lot of Wabash Cannonball, I'm thinking.
No. Yeah. But it was an interesting group of people. It was me and the Spice Girls.
And, oh, really?
Yes, and Celine Dion and Vanessa Williams and...
I love them Spice Girls, I'll tell you. Yeah. That's an amazing bunch of folks, though.
Yeah, it was, and Stevie Wonder. It was really fun to be there, be a part of it.
Had you ever been to that part of Italy before? I've never been to Italy, period.
No, we played Milan once, and I was on a tour with them and Lou Harris a few years ago, and we were there for one night, played the show and left, so I didn't get a chance to really see much of Italy at all. So we were there for 4 days this time. I got a chance to go to Venice and have a good time.
Is that where they
They like paddle everywhere?
I didn't do that.
No?
No.
I'm told that the water that they actually paddle in is pretty nasty.
I don't think you'd really want to swim in it.
No? Okay. Oh, let me hold up all the CDs here.
Please.
This is Where Your Road Leads, folks, and it's just absolutely wonderful. Absolutely fabulous. And then this would be a collection of hits.
Yes.
Songbook. These are all great records. Trisha's never made a bad record in her life, and I don't expect that she would start anytime soon. She's going to sing Perfect Love coming up next. Don't miss it.
Coming up on TNN's Primetime Country, if you have a question you've always wanted to ask Trisha, stay tuned because it could be answered next.
Oh, here's another fine song singing Perfect Love. Please welcome back Trisha Yearwood. Oh man, your band is slamming.
Thank
what a
you.
Great Give group of players. Yeah. They're leaving,
they're
but
leaving.
They're great.
They're
yeah.
leaving.
No, they're just wonderful.
Thank you.
Are you up for taking some phone call questions? These are live phone calls from our audience.
Sure.
So we never really know what's gonna happen. We screen them, but once they get on the phone, it's who knows. So let's talk to Tracy here from Massachusetts. Tracy, are you there?
Yes.
Hey, how are you?
Pretty good.
All right. How old are you?
18.
18 years old.
Hi, Tracy.
I met you four times, Trisha.
Really?
I met you in Foxwoods in September.
Oh, at Foxwoods.
And I have a web page for you.
A web page.
Oh, thank you. You were at Foxwoods. You weren't old enough to gamble, though, were you?
No.
Okay. I wasn't either.
Do you have a question, Tracy?
Yeah, I wanted to ask Trisha what her first official date with Robert was like.
Oh.
The official, I don't think we ever had an official date, actually. we met and...
I want to hear the unofficial date.
Well, here's the unofficial official date. We met in Nashville at a thing called Country Radio Seminar, where all the radio stations come here, and we were both on the same label. If we hadn't been, we probably never would have met. And just, it was one of those really corny kind of across the ice sculpture kind of things where it's like, who's that guy? And we just hit it off. And he lived in Miami at the time. The Mavericks were in Miami. And a couple of days later, he was in town. He'd never been to Nashville. They went to Graceland. They went over and did the Memphis thing. And we were going to go out to dinner, and he was staying with some friends. I went over to pick him up, and we ended up staying at their friends and just having dinner around the table and talking for hours and hours. So that was kind of our first official real date.
Where is he right now?
He's in New York right now. Hi.
Hey, Robert. How are you? And thanks, Tracy.
All right.
It's great talking to you.
Thank you. Thanks for calling.
All right. Bye-bye.
And I think we have, is Leslie from Little Rock gone away? Leslie?
I'm here.
Hi, how are you?
Hi, I'm fine. Listen, Trisha, I am a DJ in Little Rock at Kissin', and I'm just curious on what you're going to release, you know, what your next single's going to be.
Hey, Leslie. My next single is going to be the title track from the album, Where Your Road Leads.
It's a song that
I sang with Garth. So I'm excited.
That's a good one.
Thank you.
That's a real good one. We got a whole bunch of email questions also, people that we got them off the old internet, you see. Brian Cannon from Chico, California has a good question. I'm 16 years old. The question I have for you is, were you not a professional country singer, what job would you most likely have?
That's a good question. I didn't have a backup plan.
a good plan to not have one.
Yeah, I mean, I'm from a very, you know, conservative family, in which I'm proud of the way they raised me, but I was, you know, got my college education, all that, but truth be told, I would be singing somewhere if it wasn't, you know, here and in this kind of way. It would be at your local Days Inn 7 nights a week. You know, I would be doing it, so that I would, there's no other thing really for me to do.
That's great. That is great. Hey, Beverly from Baton Rouge, how are you?
Hi, I'm fine.
Yeah?
Hi, Beverly.
How you doing?
Fine, how are you?
I'm doing great. Trisha, I want to know, what is it like to work with Garth Brooks?
What is that like, anyway?
Somebody has to do it, you know. it's wonderful, I have to say. I mean, luckily he's, hopefully he's not watching.
To work with Garth Brooks, anyway.
It's really great.
How are you doing?
Doing good.
Look at you dropping in. I love this.
I was, you know, usually we're everywhere together, so if she was here, that means I was off, since I work for her now. So, thanks for the opportunity. I know we were supposed to call, but I thought we'd drop in.
No, I had heard there was a rumor you might call in, mm-hmm. and here you are, calling in.
Yeah.
Do you have a question for Trisha?
Do you have a question?
No. Not really. Can you work for any less than you're working now?
We got the rim shot going.
I don't think that's possible.
Thank you. You'll do that for anybody, won't you?
He's a soft touch. Can you hang around?
Sure, if you
can. Can you hang around and maybe strum something for him? Great. Yeah, but halfway done, folks. More music from Trisha and Garth. Come back.
Still to come on TNN's Primetime Country, more music from Trisha's brand new CD.
Yeah.
Tell me about how your hockey game is going. She says she actually drag her out on the ice and play hockey on the road.
You betcha. You betcha. So on the road, she's the man. She gets out there hockey and she just hockey. She had golf the other day. Never swung a club in her life. And first shot in front of the gallery, TV cameras and everything. It's a great shot, too.
Where'd
she
go?
Hit the cameraman. It was great. It was just...
great for you.
It was wonderful. It's great.
Are you playing a bunch of golf?
No, I play once a year, whether I really need to practice or not.
Yeah, just to
say you play did. At the Vinny once a year, but this year, you know, we're in the studio the whole time. I think that's, what, next week?
Yeah, that's next week.
So I'm sure Vince probably plays more than once a year.
He plays more than once a day. Yeah. Well, could you guys render one for us? This is such a treat to have you guys here together.
This is a piece that just keeps haunting me off her new album. It would have been a wonderful duet. Yeah, I guess some of us are thinking of others and some of us aren't. It's a beautiful melody. It's a song called She's Got a Heart Like a Sad Song. Can you hear that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Is that the key?
I'm hoping. Does that sound right to you?
It sounds low.
Does it sound low? Mm-hmm. All right, Dan.
You want it.
Yeah, I just do this right here now. Never played up here.
It's new territory.
Yeah, when she gets that high part, she's going to go.
I can sing if you be quiet.
Yeah, thank you.
You know, it's the bond that you have that makes it, yeah.
Go ahead, sing.
Okay, fine.
She loves the ones with all that wounded pride, the ones who carry all that hurt inside, who never seem to find a place they belong. She's got a heart like a sad song, and she will give them all the love she can, even when love won't give her half a chance, and she will stay with them till like a sad song. There's a wedding picture she still keeps of the girl she was and the man he seemed to be. Left her the house with a picket fence and walked away with her innocence. Now from the love comes to call, she's waiting for that other shoe to fall. Goodbye's the only thing that she's counting on. She's got a heart like a sad song. There's a wedding picture she keeps of the girl she was and the man he seemed to be. He left her the house with the picket fence and walked away with her innocence. Now from the moment that love comes to call, she's waiting for that other shoe. A sad song. She's got a heart like a sad song.
sad song. Wow, that is incredible. That is beautiful. You guys have done something like this together before, haven't you?
This is your second time to do it? We did it in, was it Seattle or Spokane?
Spokane. Put me on the spot in front of 20,000 people.
There you go.
And it was 20,000 people, and they were extremely nice and wild. We had just come off of a long neck bottle getting ready to go into fever, and she comes out.
Perfect timing.
Perfect timing.
And we do the duet, and then we do this thing called Powerful Thing off her album that's just jumping and hopping. And then we go into this. And I told her the only other time I've ever seen it was an artist here named Buddy Monlock could do this. But 20,000 people went from just totally nuts down to just, just right here. And when it was over with, you could just hear a pin drop. And then all of a sudden, boom, it just exploded. And I was doing that. And it was killing me because it was a beautiful moment. The lights come up. And then they wouldn't let her leave. I lost control of my own show. But it was, you know, it was a great way to end us touring together.
Thanks.
That's a lot.
He's taking a little nap over there. It's a union thing. He's got to check out occasionally. Hey, we're gonna run away, but trust me, we're coming back, folks. Don't go away.
Control of this show. I'm feeling exactly what you must have felt that night.
That's the touch she has.
No, you did it. What? It was you tonight. You've taken over this.
Oh, just, I have?
Yeah, just you being here. Did you, are you guys just... And thank you. You can do it anytime you want to.
Maybe I should say what you say when I come out, and I should say I want to remind everybody this is an evening with Trisha Yearwood.
Taking audience questions and email questions and phone calls, and we've got Sandy from Washington. Are you willing to talk to Sandy, Gar?
What?
You want to talk to Sandy?
Hey, Sandy.
Hey, Sandy. No, this is a different Sandy entirely. I think
I have some milk on my house.
Sandy, are you there?
Yes, I am, Gary.
Hey, you know, Garth is here with Trisha, you know. In case
I heard. What a surprise.
Yeah. Huh.
Sandy.
Hi, Trisha.
Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay. Do you have a question?
I've heard rumors of a duet album.
I'm not doing one.
No, not. No. Trisha and Garth, is it true? And if so, when's it going to be out? We really need it.
Thank you.
It's nice to hear.
I mean, they work so well together. And you know, it seems
they're
like
they're awesome together.
Thank you.
We get along so well.
I think it's pretty evident in the past that Trisha's pretty awesome with anybody. She's done duets with countless of other men. Countless number of men.
It's a long list.
It is a long list. And there at the bottom. Me, however, I have not done a duet with another female.
You know why? Because you're true.
Hey.
You're true. You're faithful.
Isn't every guy?
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right. It's about time we got balanced out here a bit.
But the duet, Sandy, we've been working real hard. We're on our second one, so it's taken a lot longer than we'd ever would have thought. The second one's on your album, Alone.
This one here?
This one right here.
This one. They came in and picked up at your local record store, country.com.
So we had this wonderful idea, if we could get MCA Records to buy off on it, to have our first actually duet album, a Christmas album of this year. It'd be a nice way to start and get a good feel for everything. See what it's like to record with each other and kill each other and scream each other and, you know, have fun together. So we're going to check into that to see if, did I say MCA yet?
I believe
MCA
you did.
Is that
the point you're trying to make?
Yes,
it seems like a subtle point. You're trying to get in
it's
here.
It's Christmas, I'm in. You in?
Yeah.
My label's in. MCA, though, that's your label, right?
Well, I'm staying out of this one, folks. Okay.
You know me and labels anyway.
Oh, yeah. No, it's been smooth sailing, hasn't it? Just pretty much a sea of glass, I'm thinking, yeah.
Yep.
Thank you very much. Great question. And I will look forward to it with you. Can you guys do another one?
I think we should definitely sing now.
I think you should.
Johnny.
This is Johnny Garcia.
Hey, Johnny, how are you, bud?
Good, how are you?
Johnny. I know you can play very well, and Trisha told me that you work, you know, relatively cheap, but do you need Johnny for this one? Is it a little beefed it up a little?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. It's nothing like on a break after we did Heart Like a Sad Song. The band actually plays the same song the right way. You can hear it going into the break. Yeah. Do you want to introduce this one?
Yeah, well, first of all, I want to introduce you to Johnny Garcia. He's been my guitar player and with me on the road for 7 years.
Hey, Johnny, I'm
going. This is another song off the new album that, that Garth knows how to play, so we're going to do it. It's called...
I drove all the way here for this.
It's called That Ain't the Way I Heard It.
Go ahead, Johnny.
3, 4.
Anytime you want that.
Yeah. After you came in late last night, you said you'd been alone. Just needed some room to clear your mind. A little time away from home. Told me you were down on Highway 9. Down by the river bend. But this town has
out of time, but I would. Could you guys do a piece of In Another's Eyes?
Yeah. Sure.
Could you give us a hunk of that?
Yeah.
And if we have to go in the middle of this,
can I?
See you guys. Don't be a stranger, and thank you for coming by.
My pleasure. Thanks, Jim.
Thank you.
In Another's Eyes, I'm someone who loves her enough to walk away from you. And I would never lie in another's eyes. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And his faith is strong. I've never
picture perfect portrait that they paint of me. They don't realize, and I pray they never do. Cause every time I look, I'm seeing you.
Airline transportation provided by Southwest Airlines, the official airline of Primetime Country.